During President Aquino's time, there were 11 to 16,000 extrajudicial killings every year. That's on the record. But ang ginawa po nung former secretary, now former secretary, former Senator De Lima, chinange nila yung definition ng extrajudicial. Kapag ka pinatay at hindi, walang kilalaman sa ideology or kaya kung siya ay religious or union, hindi na nila kinoconsider na extrajudicial. Kaya bumaba yung count ng extrajudicial killings during the Aquino time. Pagdating ng Duterte time, binalik nila yung definition na basta't napatay na hindi judicial, eh wala naman tayong death penalty nun, and as long as it's not because of natural causes, then automatically, extrajudicial killing na siya. Kaya lumobo. Having said that, it is a fact that the war on drugs or the campaign against drug produced casualties, but it is in both sides. Hindi pinapakita sa ating mga human rights advocates around the world yung mga biktima ng mga drug lord, yung mga biktima ng nagbebenta ng droga, at yung mga biktima ng drug lords versus drug lords. Finally, we did as a government, in the last government, invite many human rights groups to the Philippines. I personally had a good discussion with the former great Senator McCain, who's very close to some people in the Human Rights Watch. At ang simple lang sinabi ko, sir, the only problem of our president is yung pilit yung pinapadala, whether sila'y taga-UN or taga-human rights, ay nakapagsalita na. They're already prejudiced. Send someone who has an open mind and we will accept them. Ang problema, ang gusto nilang magpadala, yung meron ng judgment eh, na i-release na yung findings nila na violators and etc. No? So the same thing for the Foreign Minister of Iceland who spoke against us, led us against us sa Human Rights Commission. I asked for a personal meeting for him, with him. I invited him to the Philippines. Hindi pumunta. So I just like to put that in because I don't want the burden to all fall to Secretary Manalo and to Ambassador Legdameo, because it is our responsibility as a people, pati sa media, pati tayo na maging responsible. Ang problema, may mga grupo sa Pilipinas, wine-weaponize yung human rights at ginagamit to para siraan yung bansa. Now, do we have a problem with human rights? Do we have extrajudicial killings? Of course. Every single life is important. Having said that, we have to show them the whole picture and not only part of the picture. And I personally want President Marcos to continue the campaign against drugs because hindi naman pinapakita sa UN yung mga sanggol, yung mga bata, 8-year-old, nire-rape, pinapatay dahil high yung mga pumapatay. So thank you for this opportunity, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Alan. Senator Risa.
Salamat, Mr. Chair. I didn't realize we were going to review the human rights records of previous administrations. So unfortunately, hindi ko po ma-validate yung bilang ng mga sinasabing extrajudicial killings or specific types of human rights violations nung panahon ng isang dating administrasyon. It is also not fair, Mr. Chairman, to accuse a person who is not only absent from this hearing but in jail the past half decade for on charges na sa kabila nung tuloy-tuloy na pagrikant nung mga di-umanong testigo laban sa kanya, is being held unjustly para akusahan siya na minamasahin niya ang definition of terms o ang mga bilang. I think the best thing that has been said so far this morning about human rights in this hearing ay bukod dun sa sinabi ni Ambassador na he will represent our country on the issue of human rights and other important issues and common values sa community of nations bilang ating permanent representative sa UN, ay yung in-acknowledge ko at in-appreciate na sinabi ni Secretary Remulla na kahit hindi out of compliance but out of courtesy, magpo-provide sila ng information sa International Criminal Court. I just want to make those few points of record also, Mr. Chairman, in this hearing, out of a sense of fairness. And I will place my confidence in the good ambassador to represent our country better and even better on the international stage on that very important issue of human rights. Salamat, Mr. Chair.
Sir Chairman, sorry. Thank you, just have to correct that.
Senator Alan, before that, I would like to recognize the presence of our Senate President Mig Subiri.
Sir Chairman, thank you very much. I just like to put on the record, there's no unfairness. There's no accusation. I'm not accusing former Senator, former Secretary De Lima, as stated by the Lady Senator. It is a fact. It is an official act of the Secretary and the DOJ to place that definition. Everything I said is on record in the UN Human Rights Commission. It is a formal submission. I've said that in this committee, in the Senate, many, many times. If you're a human rights advocate, dapat nasa top ng head mo yung mga numbers na to, di ba? And I didn't bring up human rights here. It was the good senator who brought it up. So I just want to set the record straight because this is part of a pattern na sinisiraan yung bansa natin na para bang pagka police wala nang ginawang tama, papatayin na lang. Pagka Duterte, papatayin na lang lahat. So we have to set the record straight. May pagkakamali yung ibang mga police and they're facing prosecution now. Meron po talagang human rights violation din po yung mga drug lords na ayaw naman i-bring up. Meron talagang change of definition. I'm surprised that she doesn't know about this. But I'm not accusing Senator De Lima of that. That's a fact. It's in the records of the Senate. Nag-argue kami ni Senator De Lima sa Senate nung nag-hearing siya about this. So I'm just stating a fact. I'm not accusing anyone about anything. There's no unfairness here, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Alan.
Mr. Chair,
can we please recognize Senator Ontiveros first? Senator Risa, do you want to respond?
Just briefly, Mr. Chairman, there's also no need to question credentials of colleagues. The one whom we are confirming today is the good ambassador, no one else. And people may aver certain facts, others may correct them. Well, the human rights community knows what is what. And again, gusto ko pong pahalagahan yung sinabi ni Ambassador, nakakatawanin nilang ating bansa sa global stage on the issue of human rights. Gusto kong kilalanin at pahalagahan yung commitment ni Secre Mulya. At gusto kong pahalagahan yung track record ni Sen. Leyla, which I heard clearly was questioned. Salamat, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Risa. Congressman Marcoleta.
Mr. Chair, the only reason why the issue of human rights relate to the discussion today because of the important position of the appointee now present with us, I think we cannot take advantage of his position as the permanent representative to the United Nations, being the one in a position to deal with this in the global scale. The unfairness starts from the function of our own Human Rights Commission in this country, Mr. Chair, because as can be seen in their infographics, it seems to me that human rights can only be committed by state agents and state workers like policemen and military. That is not so, Mr. Chair. The Constitution is very clear. Even private armies and private persons can commit human rights violations. If only the Human Rights Commission in this country will redirect its orientation and include all people, because the Constitution says all forms of human rights violations. It's not only from state agents or state workers. Okay, pwede rin po kasi makapag-commit ang NPA, Abu Sayyaf, the Maute Gang in Marawi, and all this. So, para, let's put it in proper perspective. It's not only the government personnel who can commit violations of human rights. This can be committed as well, even by private persons and private armies. Mr. Chair, for the record, salamat po.
Thank you, Congressman Marcoleta. Senator Risa, again.
Salamat, Mr. Chair. Just last on this point, I concur with Representative Marcoleta. Kahit po yung mga non-state agents, may obligasyon sa human rights at accountable kapag lumabag sila sa human rights as various non-state agents have done. At the same time, yung Estado po ang primary duty bearer at tayong lahat na nagtatrabaho sa Estado ay primary duty bearer din. Salamat, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Riza.